Hello, I'm Dr. Bob Arnott, and I'm so pleased to welcome you to this wonderful patriotic concert by the Medical Musical Group, taped live at the Schlesinger Concert Hall in Alexandria, Virginia. Now, our special thanks, first of all, to Deanna Martin, Daniel Rodriguez, General Richard Myers, and to all the other many distinguished participants. A very special thanks to our heroes, America's service members and veterans. They are our nation's pride as they defend liberty at home and overseas. I've traveled all over the world, and everywhere I went with them, I saw firsthand the generosity of the American people, and particularly America's military and veterans. A particular word of appreciation to the Medical Musical Group. These musicians are healers, physicians and nurses from the VA and other medical centers and schools throughout the United States, as well as other volunteers. Now, they traveled here at their own expense to take part in this concert. I hope, and in fact know, that you will immensely enjoy this wonderful program. May God bless our soldiers and veterans, and may He bless our beloved America. Thank you so much for watching, and enjoy the show.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Dick Kuntz, a member of the Medical Musical Group, and it is my pleasure and honor to welcome you to our concert commemorating the 70th anniversary of the end of World War II. Veterans are the core of the mission of our Medical Musical Group. In fact, some people call us Doctors Without Borders for veterans. And we are proud of it. I'd like to introduce now our concertmaster, Dr. Richard Chen, who in his day job is Chief of Anesthesiology at the West Los Angeles VA Medical Center and Professor of Anesthesiology at UCLA Medical School. Dr. Chen. Dr. Chen. Ladies and gentlemen, a housekeeping item. In case you didn't hear me about 10 minutes ago, please turn off your cell phones. Also, please help us keep track of our audience by filling the blue audience response card that you received at the door. It looks like this. Give the completed cards to our ushers in the intermission, and we will have a drawing after the concert. We'll give away 10 complimentary DVDs to the winners.
On behalf of the soldiers and sailors and veterans at the Armed Forces Retirement Home, and on behalf of all of America's veterans, I want to recognize the Medical Musical Group's sacrificial giving of time and effort in performing these marvelous and inspiring concerts. We sincerely appreciate that. Tonight, I'd like to offer a very special salute to the veterans of our greatest generation. So, ladies and gentlemen, now let me belt out a familiar battle cry. Live from Alexandria, Virginia, it's the Medical Musical Group concert commemorating the 70th anniversary of the end of World War II.
Thank Thank you, Phil. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Maestro William Jones, who will direct our orchestra and chorus in the national anthem. And the Color Guard of the Sons of the American Revolution will present the colors in American Revolutionary uniform. Please rise now for the singing of the national anthem. Maestro Jones.
Sabrina Clark and tenor Daniel Rodriguez, all directed by Barbara Steffen, director of the Nova Light Chorale of Arlington, Virginia. Maestra, if you please.
To be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, but at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the man who died, who gave this right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today.
Thank you.
to bring a word of welcome from Veterans Service Organizations is Mr. Charles Eggleston of the Military Order of the Purple Heart. Mr. Eggleston, please.
Good afternoon. I'd like to bring greetings from the Military Order of the Purple Heart, representing ourselves, also speaking on behalf of many other veteran service organizations. I'm very pleased to welcome a wonderful patriotic concert by the Medical Musical Group, and also know that we've been taped live at this time at the great Schlossinger Concert Hall here in Alexandria, Virginia. Special thanks, and a very special thanks, may I add, to Dina Martin, Danielle Rodriguez, General Richard Myers, and to all many distinguished guests. Also, I'd like to give a heartfelt greeting to our heroes serving overseas and abroad, and our hometown heroes as well, and also our veterans. Don't forget our veterans. They are our nation's pride by defending our liberties and our justice, home and abroad. I usually see this firsthand, and I say to myself, as others, you know, freedom is not free, and we are ever grateful to our military and our veterans for guarding our precious gift. A particular word, appreciation, to the musical group. These musicians are great healers, physicians, nurses from VA centers abroad and around our great nations, and medical schools, may I ask. As they travel at their own expense to be a part of this great concert, I'd like to give them applause for doing so and for their great patriotism. So from us, the Military Order of Purple Heart, we appreciate the patriotism and labor by all of these great souls. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Eggleston, for your words and for your distinguished service. We appreciate the support of the Military Order of the Purple Heart. I can only imagine. And he started to tell me what happened that led to his Purple Heart, but even still, I can only imagine what he had to do, what he had to go through to get that Purple Heart. So thank you so much for that. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the chorus will perform "It Is Well With My Soul," a beautiful hymn that was performed at the Charleston, South Carolina Memorial Service attended by the President just a few weeks ago. It is said to err is human and to forgive is divine. And who was not moved by the grace of the families who forgave the person who murdered their loved one? So we thought this hymn would fit very well with the message of national healing, which is at the center of this concert. Maestro Kelvin Page will direct the chorus. Maestro Page?
indeed. And now Mr. Page will direct the chorus in an Andrew Sisters song, one that you probably know, very much associated with World War II. It is Don't Sit Under the Apple Tree. And soloists are Sabrina Clark, Susan Joy Bechet, Karen Andrea, William Jones, and Dick Koontz. Mr. Page?
Keep the show moving along. Let's welcome the medical musical group's great friend, Dr. Joseph Gutierrez, to bring a word of greetings from the DC Medical Society. Dr. Gutierrez.
Thank you very much and good evening. It gives me great pleasure on behalf of the Medical Society of the District of Columbia to welcome you to this evening's concert. You've heard music that's been inspiring, uplifting, foot stomping, but most of all, relaxing. I hope that you have a relaxing time. Sit back and enjoy the rest of the evening. You have a wonderful concert ahead of you. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Dr. Gutierrez. We truly appreciate your words and also the support of the Medical Society. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we have an extra special treat. We have the one and only Dina Martin. Dina is, of course, a very popular singer, actress, and performer, and the very proud daughter of iconic entertainer Dean Martin. Voila, or should I say, Volare.
Yeah.
Dina achieved success early in her career in films, theater, and television, then quickly added to her repertoire recording artist, best-selling author, and, get this, licensed pilot. How cool is that? Dina's going to sing three favorites, G.I. Jive, Nothing But the Best, and The Lady is a Tramp. She will sing with the orchestra directed by Dr. Joseph Carr. Dr. Carr and Dina, please take us away.
She gets too hungry
for dinner at 8. She loves the theater, but never goes late. And she'd never bother with people she'd hate. That's why the lady is a tramp. Doesn't like dice games with barons and earls. Won't go to Harlem in ermine and pearl. Won't dish the dirt with the rest of the girls. That's why that lady is a tramp. She loves the free, fresh wind in her hair. Life without care. She's broke, but it's dope. Hates California, cause it's cold and damp. That's why that lady's a tramp. She gets too hungry to wait for dinner at 8. She loves the theater, but never, 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 never goes there. She would never bother with those people that she hates. That's why that lady is a tramp. Doesn't like dice games with sharpies or frogs. Won't go to Harlem in Lincoln's or Ford's. And she will not dish the dirt with the rest of the broads. That's why that lady is a tramp. She loves the free, fresh cuckoo wind in her hair. Life without care. She's broke, but it's open. Hates California, cause it's cold and damp. That's why that lady, that is why the lady, that's why that chick is a champ. Woo!
Very nice. Are they fabulous? Thank you, Dr. Carr. Beautiful. They're swinging tonight. And thank you. It's an honor for me to be back here again this year. We had such fun last year. And I want to say thank you to all of our servicemen. Thank you. And women, of course, and their families. The greatest generation from this is the end of World War II. 70 years. Fantastic. Thank you for letting me be a part of this. It's an honor. So we're singing all of these incredible, fabulous songs. You probably wondered why I sang Lady is a Tramp. But it was written in 1937, and then it became a huge hit, you know, in the 40s, all through the war years. And my Uncle Frank Sinatra, he would be 100 years old this December, so I wanted to honor him. And this next song I sang last year, and it was written by Johnny Mercer, and it's for all of you GIs out there. Here we go. This is the G.I. Joe, man alive. It starts with the bugle blowing reveille over your bed when you arrive. Jack, that's the G.I. Joe. Rudely toot, out of your suit, make with your flute. And after you wash and dress, more or less, you go get your breakfast in a beautiful little cafe they call the Mess. Jack, when you come left out of your seat, into the street, make with your feet. Your PVG, your duty is to salute the L-I-E-U-T. But if you brush the L-I-E-U-T, the MP makes you KP on the QD. This is the G.I. Jive, man alive. It's if you a private tank that features a little device called Fluid Drive. Jack, after you revive, chuck all your junk back in your trunk, fall on your bunk, flunk. If your PVT, your duty is to salute the L-I-E-U-T. But if you brush the L-I-E-U-T, The MP makes you cave beyond the QT. This is a GI job, man alive. They give you a private tank that features a little device called fluid drive. Jack, if you still survive, shuck all your junk back in your trunk, fall on your bunk. Look, soon you're counted cheap, but before you count too far, G.I. Jive, written by Johnny Mercer. And, you know, during the 40s, you know, my dad, of course, worked with Jerry Lewis from 46. Remember Martin and Lewis? Yes, and they did, they worked for 10 years from 46 to 56, but they did a movie called At War with the Army. Remember that? The Navy gets the gravy, but the Army gets, no, the Army gets, the Navy gets the gravy, but the Army gets the beans, 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 beans. You don't remember that one? You do. All right. Well, in honor again of all of you and my Uncle Frank Sinatra, I'm going to sing a song that was written with Johnny Mercer, with Johnny and Johnny Rotella, who are friends of mine. And the first time he gave this song away, it was to Frank Sinatra. And we're going to do that for you right now because you are nothing but the best. I like a new Lincoln with all of its class. I like a martini and burn under glass. I'm gonna start living, you wait and see. Nothing but the best is good enough for me. I like to eat lobster directly from Maine. I like to see bullfights in sunny old Spain. I'm gonna start living, you wait and see. Nothing but the best is good enough for me. Tally ho, off we go. Who can wait another day? You and me on a spree. Let's get started right away. Oh, we're gonna go traveling and have us a fling. We'll visit a palace, we're gonna dine with a king. We're gonna start living, you wait and see. Nothing but the best is good enough for me. Gonna go traveling and have us a fling. We'll visit a palace, you're gonna buy me a ring. We're gonna start living, you wait and see. There'll be nothing but the best, caviar and all the rest. Nothing but the best is good enough for me. Thank you so much. Thank you, Dr. Carr. And Rick Creevy, thank you very much, my musical director. And thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Fabulous. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. That was just fantastic, Dina. And Dina is not just beautiful and a great singer, she's also a fantastic lunch date.
Oh,
we had
yes.
lunch yesterday. She told me about getting her first singing lesson ever in life from Uncle Frank. How amazing is that?
Not a bad deal there.
And she talked about being 13 years old and wearing a tuxedo made for Uncle Sammy.
Uncle Sammy Davis Jr., unbelievable.
And how Dad used to come out and say, oh, my seven kids are here, and everyone would applaud. And don't applaud for that. It only took me 7 minutes.
That's right. I had no idea what that meant.
Still don't. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. You're doing a great job, and thank you to everybody. And thank you. God bless you. Thank you.
And Dr. Carr, thank you too, sir. So now, ladies and gentlemen, a salute to our service members who are here and the active duty military. This is your moment for the veterans and the active military. It is the point of the program where we play the Armed Forces medley. When your service song is played, sing along, stand up, wave your hands, stomp your feet, wave your handkerchief in the air, whatever you want to do.
And to call the services, we are lucky to have Major General Margaret Wilmoth, Deputy Surgeon General of the Army Reserve. Also, Commander U.S. Navy retired Steve Tomlin of the USO, and the Honorable Craig Deering, former Assistant Secretary of the Air Force. And the presentation will be presided over by the distinguished former Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, General Richard Myers. We are, of course, incredibly honored to have General Myers with us, and you're going to see more of him later in the program. He's going to narrate parts of our integrated program of music and readings. That's going to happen in the second half of the concert, so something to look forward to there.
Yeah, that's going to be really exciting. And Dr. Carr is going to direct this part. And before we get started, we're going to have a little greeting, of course, from General Myers.
Well, thank you, Torrey, and thank all of you for being here. I'm really happy to be with you today, and I really appreciate the fact the concert pays tribute to our service members and veterans. And having served in the ranks for many years, I can tell you what each one of them would say when facing anyone who would try to do America harm. Each of our men and women would say, not now, not here, not on my watch. Maestro, it's all yours.
United States Coast Guard.
Our
Well, that was all a lot of fun. Thank you all so much. Thank you to all of you for your service and sacrifice. And we actually thought now would be a perfect moment to recognize all of our veterans, active and reserve military, that are out in the audience. And we're going to do this in two steps today. First, we're going to recognize our veterans of the greatest generation. So I'd like all of you World War II veterans who are out there in the audience, please stand up now and be recognized. And if you can't stand, wave your hand or simply hold your chin up high. We honor all of our dear veterans, and we so appreciate your service and your sacrifice. Thank you so much. Thank you.
So much for your service. And now let's recognize veterans of all the wars and active or reserve military. Stand up and be recognized. And again, if you can't stand, wave your hand or just hold your chin up high. We honor all of you.
Thank you so much to all of you. We can't tell you how much we appreciate your service and your sacrifice. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to come to a very high point of our concert. It is the Veterans Moment, where we perform our award-winning Veterans Hymn, which was written by medical musical group founder Dr. Victor Wabi. So here are soloists Sabrina Clark, Susan Joy Bechet, Kelvin Page, and Steve Arnold with the ensemble to sing the Veterans Hymn, and Dr. Joe Carr will direct the ensemble again.
And ladies and gentlemen, during verse 3 of the hymn, the cadets from the Civil Air Patrol Challenger 1 Squadron will perform a vacant chair dramatization, and we'll recognize our cherished Gold Star mothers and families in the audience. So I kindly ask you, dear ladies, when we reach the third verse, please stand at that time.
And all of you out there in the audience are not left down. If you have your program for the evening, take it out, take a look at it. You're going to find the lyrics on the back of that program. Please listen carefully to verse 2 because it is going to come again. It's going to be verse 4 as well. And when it does, please join in the choir and singing along. So without further ado, Dr. Carr, take it away.
Oh, matter
much. That was so moving, so valuable. Dr. Carr, that was fantastic. All of you who participated in singing that and playing that, extraordinary. All of them received the Congressional Medal of Honor Society's Bob Hope Award for that. And of course, we can now see why that
certainly happened. See why that was the case. And to the Gold Star mothers and Gold Star families watching you rise during that vacant chair dramatization, incredibly powerful, incredibly moving. Thank you, and God bless all of you. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is time for a little intermission. We have a 15-minute intermission so that you can stretch your legs a bit, but we are not going to leave you alone. During that time, Dr. Steve Arnold will perform a beautiful song composed by Elton John and licensed to the Spirit of 45 campaign to commemorate this very 70th anniversary. Enjoy.
Coming up soon, MMG's 25th Annual Veterans Day Concert, Sunday, November 1st at 4 p.m. Eastern. Schlesinger Concert Hall, Alexandria, Virginia. Info and order tickets at www.medicalmusical.org or call 202-797-0700. Order a full-length DVD of this and other MMG concerts. Only $15 per DVD plus $5 shipping and handling for up to 3 DVDs. Info and order DVDs at www.medicalmusical.org or call 202-797-0700. With us. MMG UK Tour, Jolly Good Britannia 2015. November 3rd through 12th, 2015, MMG Healing the Nations Concert. Central Hall, Westminster, London, England. Info at www.medicalmusical.org. Telephone 202-797-0700.
We're gonna start living. You wait and there'll be nothing but the best. Caviar and all the rest. Nothing but the best.
Contact us. Support MMG. If you like this broadcast, tell your friends about us. MMG is the world's premier joint medical, chorale, and symphony orchestra. MMG members are volunteers who cover their travel and other expenses. However, production light items, professional audio, and video are quite expensive. Contributions to MMG are welcome, and they are tax deductible. To donate to MMG, visit www.medicalmusical.org. Coming up soon, MMG's 25th Annual Veterans Day Concert, Sunday, November 1st at 4 p.m. Eastern. Schlesinger Concert Hall, Alexandria, Virginia. Info and order tickets at www.medicalmusical.org or call 202-797-0700. Order a full-length DVD of this and other MMG concerts. Only $15 per DVD plus $5 shipping and handling for up to 3 DVDs. Info and order DVDs at www.medicalmusical.org or call 202-797-0700. travel with us. MMG UK Tour, Jolly Good Britannia 2015. November 3rd through 12th, 2015, MMG Healing the Nations Concert. Central Hall, Westminster, London, England. Info at www.medicalmusical.org. Telephone 202-797-0700.
We're going to start living. You wait and see. There'll be nothing but the best. Caviar and all the rest. Nothing but the best.
Contact us. Support MMG. If you like this broadcast, tell your friends about us. MMG is the world's premier joint medical, chorale, and symphony orchestra. MMG members are volunteers who cover their travel and other expenses. However, production light items, professional audio and video are quite expensive. Contributions to MMG are welcome and they are tax deductible. To donate to MMG, visit www.medicalmusical.org. Coming up soon, MMG's 25th Annual Veterans Day Concert, Sunday, November 1st at 4 p.m. Eastern. Schlesinger Concert Hall, Alexandria, Virginia. Info and order tickets at www.medicalmusical.org or call 202-797-0700.
I'm going to play a song for you written by Elton John, and it's called Oceans Away. It's a lovely tune remembering all of those who fought in World War II.
I hung out with the old folks in the hope that I'd get wise. I was trying to bridge the gap in between the great divide. Hung on every recollection in the theater of their eyes. Picking up on this and that in the few that still survive. Dust them off, let them shine, the ones that hold on to the ones they had to leave behind. Those who flew, those who fell, the ones who had to stay, neath a little wooden cross, oceans away. They bend like trees in winter, the shuffling old gray lions. Those snow-white stars still gather like the belt around Orion, just to touch the faded lightning of their powerful design, of a generation gathering for maybe one last time. Call on them up, dust them off, let them shine, the ones who had to hold on to the ones they left behind. Those who flew, those who fell, those that had to stay, neath a little wooden cross, oceans away. Oceans away.
And And now, ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you to this part two of tonight's concert. Let us first welcome our concertmaster, Dr. Richard Chen, to tune up the orchestra. Dr. Chen. Thank you, Dr. Chen. Again, two quick housekeeping announcements. Ladies and gentlemen, please remember to fill in the audience response card and hand them over to the ushers. And remember to turn off your cell phones. Please take note of our upcoming 2015 Veterans Day concert. It will be on Sunday, November 1st at 4 p.m. right here at the Schlesinger Center. So mark your calendar for November 1st. And now, please welcome back your wonderful hosts for the evening, Ture and Crystal Ball.
Everybody have a good break? Everybody like part one? I sure did. Well, if you liked part one, you like part one?
I love part one, personally.
If you like part one, you're gonna love part two, because there's a great energy to it, trust me, work
Indeed.
With me. So, ladies and gentlemen, a signature feature of these concerts by our medical musical group is an integrated thematic segment of readings and music, sort of music with a message. Tonight's theme, Just the Facts, which y'all will remember from the great television show Dragnet. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
However, the setting of tonight's Dragnet is literally out of this world, but wait till you see for yourself. I promise it is going to be very exciting.
Crystal and I are going to join in the program narrations along with many great special guests who will serve as distinguished narrators.
Indeed. Let's actually have our narrators come out so we can introduce them. Narrators, come on out. In alphabetical order, they are former Maryland Secretary of Veterans Affairs, the Honorable Edward Chow. Also, distinguished Daily Beast journalist and McLaughlin Group panelist, the one and only Eleanor Clift. Grandson of President Harry S. Truman, Clifton Truman Daniel. And football star, former New England Patriot, Daryl Haley.
Daryl Sabin, you gotta talk to him about the Super Bowl sometime, man. The 85 Super Bowl against the Bears, fantastic. Also, our friend, Dina Martin. Dina.
Welcome back.
And the distinguished former chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, a great patriot, General Richard Myers. Sir, television star Deborah Smyers. And Chief Operating Officer of the USO Metro, Steve Tomlin. Welcome back, Steve. This segment features the chorale and orchestra. At this time, I'd like to recognize our distinguished soloists who will come out when their solo parts are called. We're talking about soprano Sabrina Clark, mezzo Susan Joy Bechet, and tenor Daniel Rodriguez, and of course, baritone Steve Arnold.
I'm really excited for this part of this event. It's going to be really fast moving and it's going to be integrated. The narrations have been written by our medical maestro and founder of the medical musical group, Dr. Victor Wabi. Dr. Wabi, take us away.
Ladies and gentlemen, the story that you are about to hear may or may not be true.
However, the names have not been changed since they do not need to be protected.
Just the facts, ma'am. Just the facts. Just the facts, sir. Just the facts. Just the facts, ladies and gentlemen. Just the facts.
So
Sunday afternoon, August 16th, Schlesinger Concert Hall, Alexandria, Virginia. Distinguished assembly, the Lord God Almighty looks on high, very, very high, turns to his chief of staff, Michael, that is, and says, just the facts, Michael, just the facts.
The really big boss asked Michael, Michael, I know why I created the sun, and I know why I created the moon. I know why I created ice cream, and I even know why I created Coca-Cola. But Michael, remind me, why did I create America?
Just the facts, Michael. Just the facts.
Michael flaps his wings, clears his angelic throat, and responds to the divine inquiry. Michael now answers with utmost respect. Well, sir, you have had the Pharaohs, the Phoenicians, the Assyrians, the Babylonians, the Hittites, the Malachites, the Greeks, the Romans, etc., etc., etc. However so, sir, those American folks are different, very different.
Well, sir, contended Michael, these Americans have a special place for you in their national psyche. They describe their unalienable rights as endowed by you. They mint their coins with a declaration that in you they trust. They open their national meetings with prayers to you. And their favorite wish to each other at the end of these meetings is that you, sir, may bless America.
And, sir, when they pledge allegiance to their star-spangled banner, they describe their nation as one nation, indivisible, under you.
Thank you.
America, a continent hidden in the fog of the oceans for thousands of years, finally emerged, as Herman Melville wrote, to become the bearer of the ark of the liberties of the world and the arsenal of democracy.
Precisely 70 years ago today, America and her allies sealed in victory the final chapter of the most destructive war in world history.
The casualties of World War II far exceeded 50 million people. Death and destruction were everywhere. A horrible hurricane of darkness swirled over the earth for 6 years.
President Harry Truman, whose grandson I am honored to be, used to say, America was not built on fear. America was built on courage, on imagination, and an unbeatable determination to do the job at hand.
Yes, Clifton, and he also famously said, the buck stops here. And Providence chose President Truman to help put an end to the nightmare, which was World War II.
America always stood up to tyranny.
Listen to those sparkling words by Thomas Jefferson. I have sworn upon the altar of God eternal hostility against every form of tyranny over the mind of man.
We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men and women are created equal, and that they, endowed by their Creator, with certain unalienable rights.
O beautiful, for heroes proved, in liberating strife, who more than self their country loved, and mercy more than life.
O beautiful, for pilgrim feet, whose stern and passionate stress a thoroughfare of freedom beat across the wilderness.
America, America, may God thy gold refine.
Till all success be nobleness, and every gain divine.
Tennyson wrote a famous poem about the battle which the British Army fought in the year 1854 in none other than, yes, the Crimea. Tennyson's poem is entitled The Charge of the Light Brigade, and it eerily is reminiscent of the challenges our valiant men and women in uniform face every day all over the world.
Wrote Tennyson, "There's not to make reply, there's not to reason why, there's but to do and die. Into the valley of death rode the 600.
Cannon to the right of them, cannon to the left of them, Cannon behind them, volleyed and thundered.
Honor the charge they made, honor the Light Brigade, Noble 600.
And today, as we remember our fallen heroes who gave the last measure of devotion, we say to them, with love and gratitude, in our hearts you will live evermore, precious names that we will always adore.
We shall never, ever forget you.
Many factors contributed to our victory in World War II.
Obviously, our military strength was foremost. However, the undergirding factor was that we were a united nation, completely focused on the common mission, which was victory.
Oh, how much we need that unity today. Scripture warns us that a house divided on itself cannot stand. And so, our greatest need at this moment is national unity and healing.
And so let the word go from this time and place that we are one nation, one people, one homeland. Not blue states, not red states, but the United States of America.
And from the deepest recesses of our beings, we lift up a very serious and heartfelt prayer. Lord God Almighty, please, would you please heal our land?
Thank you.
Friends, Americans, countrymen, and women, lend me your ears. As we celebrate America's history of fighting tyrannies, and as we now face dangerous enemies, foreign and domestic,
we today will fight the tyranny of terror, and we will defeat it on every battleground and in every battlefield.
In Puccini's opera, Turandot, a popular song is Nessun Dorma, where the prince defiantly sings, Allah Vincero.
Or in English, in the morning, I will be victorious. So without hesitation, doubt, or complaint, we shall endure the long night of the battle, knowing that in the end, we shall prevail. Liberty will prevail.
In 1776, at the Constitutional Convention, John Adams of Massachusetts rose and said,
"While I live, let me have a country, a free country."
And as I think tonight of those early patriots and also of our heroes, the veterans, and our young men and women in uniform defending freedom all around the world,
I am reminded of the immortal and lofty words of another great American patriot, Patrick Henry of Virginia.
"Why stand we here idle? What is it that gentlemen and gentlewoman wish?
I know not what course others may take, but as for me, give me liberty or give me death."
Thank you.
These were and are the facts, ladies and gentlemen. Just the facts.
The facts simply are that 70 years ago, we fought, we won, and we were united.
And you don't need a crystal ball, even one as beautiful as my friend, to know deep in your heart
that in the future, in order to be victorious again, we must be united.
And these, ladies and gentlemen, are the facts. Just the facts. Just the facts.
And after discussing all these matters, God said to Michael, "Well then, go forth, Michael. Remind these folks that when I first dreamed of America, I had in mind certain plans for them, a vision, a mission, a direction, and a destiny."
Then God said, "Go and tell these people, I am not done with you yet. The vision endures. The mission lasts. Go forth and be a city on a hill where grace and truth abide, a light to the nations."
This fictional chat between God and Michael reminds one of the words of the ancient Hebrew prophet Isaiah.
Said Isaiah of old, "Mine eyes have seen the Lord, sitting upon the throne, high and lifted up, and the posts of the doors moved at the voice of him that cried."
And Isaiah shouted out, "Here I am, send me."
Ladies and gentlemen, the challenge, and in fact the mission, is still here if you wish to accept it.
To go and tell a hurting America, now faith, hope, and love abide. These three, but the greatest of these is love.
Ladies and gentlemen, these are the facts, and that is the mission. What say ye?
With the glory in his bosom. bosom that transfigures you and me. As he died to make men holy, let us live to make men free while God is marching on.
Special historic moment of the Pacific Theater of World War II. Now, I don't want to do a spoiler alert. I know some people are a little bit younger, may not know how it ends, so I don't want to ruin it for them. So watch the stage for that.
But we do want to say that the dramatization in this segment is provided by the very talented young people of the Northern Virginia Community College Drama Department under the leadership of Professor Kate Alshama. They will perform a reenactment of a World War II scene that is certainly etched deep in our memories, so make sure you watch carefully for that. And at the same time, we will share in saluting Old Glory by singing "You're a Grand Old Flag, Maestro," if you please. I don't think that this incredible concert would quite be complete without Seuss's Stars and Stripes. What do you all think?
Yeah.
And I did hear a rumor that our group has a signature sing-along of that march that will literally make you jump out of your seat. Believe it or not, members of Congress would even jump out of their seat at this. Yes, folks, miracles do still happen. And the other thing that I think we're going to do here is I understand there is going to be a competition between the men and the women, all of you out there. So I asked Daniel Rodriguez, representing the men, and Dina Martin, representing the ladies, to please come to the podium so that they can serve as judges as to who wins, wherever you want to be. Meanwhile, let me ask our maestro to explain exactly how this is all going to work.
Now, I mentioned this before. We have done this all over the world. very few times the men won. I have no idea. So maybe today, on the 70th anniversary, with Daniel Rodriguez's leadership, but who can compete with the Dina? Dina Volare. So take your cue from the chorus. When the women in the chorus stand up, you stand up and so on. Then when we come on the repeat, we have everybody stand up with the brass. You can take your cue from the chorus. We do a lot of tricks in the piece. We hurry up sometimes and slow down, and sometimes we pause down completely, close up completely. So don't get lost in the jungle. And watch these two. I think you'll do well. I can predict now who will win.
First, I said to Crystal, wow, that's going to be very hard to beat. They sound great. I see lots of smiles. They're very beautiful. But then my brothers came out sounding great. And I said, well, there's no way that they could lose.
They sounded okay. What do you think, Dina? What do you think?
Well, you guys are biased.
I think the men were great, but the women were unbelievable.
That's true.
Well, I have to say that the women were unbelievable.
But
I've got to go home to my woman, so they were very unbelievable. Guys, you were great, but she's watching on television. The ladies have it.
Smart man.
Daniel said, happy wife, happy life. Y'all got it.
That's
good for
words
you.
Of wisdom there.
Congratulations.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is time for our grand finale, and I would say that nothing is more fitting than God Bless America. And let me ask Dr. Steve Arnold to lead in that singing, and let us call all of our distinguished narrators to join us here at the front of the stage to help us with this number. Come on up so you can sing along.
Dr. Wabi, I have this great just feeling of joy inside. That was so fun, so awesome. I feel connected to all you guys. This is awesome. Thank you so much.
Would like an encore? What do you think?
Oh.
What do you think, Dr. Wabi?
Let's do a little more then.
Okay, encore first. Before we give our distinguished host here an extra round of applause,
That's
I think
so
we
sweet.
Got
oh,
more
thank
music.
You.
Thank you.
incredible evening.
Wait. I'm not ready for it to end. Are you ready for it to end? Well, let's, you know what I would like to hear? I would like to hear a little more of Daniel Rodriguez. Is he extraordinary or what?
He is amazing.
Can we get Daniel back onto the stage?
Maybe Ness and Dorma again? Can we get Ness and Dorma again?
Let's see if we can clap Dan back onto the stage.
For punishment, you're a sadist. Nessa Dorm is like one of those once a night songs. So hey, why not?
That's why we want to hear it twice.
Thank you for the honor of being here this evening.
Afternoon, early evening. I am so glad you guys were here with us.
Wait. I got one more thing on my list. Ladies, should we give the guys one more chance at the Stars and Stripes? Should we give them
the
one more shot?
No. No. Guys, should we get one more chance at this competition?
Should we get
Dina
and Daniel back up here one more time? Let's close it out with Stars and Stripes.
We're going home tonight, anytime?
This is it. I promise. This is all.
Thank you.
awesome. I think the women beat us again. We have gone on longer than even James Brown would have gone on. Thank you all for being here. Thank you, Dr. Wahby. Thank you, all these amazing musicians and singers. Thank you for all these amazing stars who joined us tonight. Thank you all for your service, and have a good night.
Sounds of the guns have been stilled. This is August the 14th, the day to remember.
On August 14th, 1945, spontaneous celebrations broke out across our country at the news that the most destructive war in human history was over, and America immediately began to lay the foundations for a better world for both its friends and former enemies alike. Some have called it our greatest generation's greatest day.
We are rapidly disappearing. But our legacy must live on so that it can inspire future generations of Americans.
So please join us this summer to honor the memory of the members of our greatest generation and help keep the spirit of 45 alive.
Hungry for dinner at 8. She loves the theater, but never goes late. And she'd never bother with people she'd hate. That's why the lady is a tramp. Doesn't like dice games with barons and ermines. Won't go to Harlem in ermine and pearl. Won't dish the dirt with the rest of the girls. That's why that lady is a tramp. She loves the free, fresh wind in her hair. Life without care. She's broke, but it's open. Hates California 'cause it's cold and damp. That's why that lady is a tramp. She gets too hungry to wait for dinner at 8. She loves the theater, but never, 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 never goes. And she would never bother with those people that she hates. That's why that lady is a tramp. Doesn't like dice games with Sharpies or Frost. Won't go to Harlem in Lincoln's or Ford's. And she will not dish the dirt with the rest of the broads. That's why that lady is a tramp.